Hi guys, Firebox here, coming to you with another video, and today I'm going to be showing you guys my latest mock. It is Obi-Wan's Jedi Starfighter from Star Wars Episode 2 Attack of the Clones. Now, the design here, I tried replicating every single piece of detail that you see on the Starfighter. I think I achieved it really well. I don't know if you can see it from the camera angle, but I'm really happy with the way this turned out. The only thing that I could probably progress with it is probably tiles. Unfortunately, I've not got very many dark red tiles in my collection, as well as the fact that they're quite hard to find. So, yeah guys, let's get a closer look at this Starfighter. Anyway, so we're starting here at the wings. As you can see, of course, it's dark red. Now, the shape and design is replicated on both sides, apart from the fact that you have R4P17 on the right side, and which actually came from the Planet series, where it came with Kamino as well as Obi-Wan's Jedi Starfighter, and then also the fact that there's a Republic insignia on the left wings. So yep, here I just have a top view of course, the Delta-7 Starfighter. As you can see, it looks beautiful from the top view. Of course, you see the intricate design of it. I think the overall design in the actual film is quite nice because, of course, you have the sharp edges going up, and of course, they're really made for Jedi. Well, only Jedi. Mostly because they go that fast and only Jedi reflexes will be able to do it. And then of course you have the guns towards the side here, which is just replicated using these type of Jango Fett blasters, which is kind of convenient because of course this episode took Attack of the Clones, which is where you see this Starfighter, as well as the fact that you also see Jango Fett. Front here, of course, there's a 1x8 white tiles here, as well as a couple of wedge pieces, just to give it that nice shape. And then, of course, you have a 1x2 light green tile here, as well as a grill piece here, just to give it that extra detail. And then you have a 1x4 here, that's attached using a jumper piece there, and that just kind of gives it a nice shape. As you can see, on the actual wing, I forgot to mention this, but you got somewhat of a pattern here, and that's replicated on both sides. And you actually see that on the actual Starfighter. So yeah, I just thought I'd add that in. Anyway, so continuing on with the middle here, as you can see, it does kind of slope up, as you can see. Unfortunately, I don't have the actual Lego one to compare this one to, but I'm pretty sure the Lego set that came with the hyperdrive ring, this part was just too bulky, so I made sure my mock wasn't too bulky. I think it's replicated really well here. And then of course you have the cockpit here. Now the cockpit itself was actually really hard to Well, not really hard, but it was probably the most challenging part to do because the cockpit has a somewhat of a unique shape. It's quite hard to replicate in Lego, but there are certain ways, and unfortunately I didn't have those pieces. I think it's like a car piece or something like that, but I didn't have any in my collection, so I just used these 2x2 wedge pieces here, or slope pieces. As well as a couple of bracket pieces on the side, just to get it on the, like these pieces on the side here. And I think I replicated the shape really well. I'm happy with the way it turned out. And then, of course, yeah, the cockpit windshield can obviously open, and then you can take your Obi-Wan minifigure out. Now he's just held on using this piece here, which has got, like, of course, like a T-bar in the middle, so you can put your minifigure inside, which has actually came in quite a lot of sets recently, and he just fits straight down in there. Unfortunately, you cannot have his arms down because, of course, the way that I built the sides here. But you're better off to just keep it like that and then you close the cockpit. Anyway, so going back to, well, going to the back here, as you can see, there's quite a lot of light green pieces here. That includes a couple of cheese wedge pieces, slope pieces, and 1x3 slope pieces as well. As well as a few wedge plates towards the back here of the left and right wing. And I think it kind of gives it that nice Starfighter look that you get for all the Delta-7 Starfighters. At the back here, excuse that, that's the wind. As you can see, the engines here are just replicated using these white wheel pieces. And then, of course, you have the fin, which is not really studied in. It's only studied in through these pieces here. I think it's actually turned out very well. It's very nice stability-wise, because you can literally hold the entire ship using that back piece. So I think I did a really good job on keeping that together, if my camera will focus. There we go. And that's just replicated using some wedge pieces as well. They're not connected here, which is a sacrifice for all of them. So it kind of gives it a little bit of that small gap. But it's still really good. And then of course you get the right wing at the corner of this Republic insignia. Couple of wedge pieces, I think it's just the exact same on the other side. The underside is a bit messy, unfortunately, just a sacrifice needed in order to get the wings very stable. As you see, these wings are not coming apart at all, and that's really because of these plates here. Before that, if I didn't have these plates, it would just break apart. But I managed to get it. Unfortunately, there's no landing gear. I was unable to include it because, of course, it just wouldn't be very nice stability-wise. The wings are actually just held on using a couple of clip pieces here. As you can see, it's replicated both sides. And, of course, you can change the angle, but there's this cockpit piece here that kind of just stops it from going any further. I think that just gets it to the right place. So let's go on to the final part of this video. So yeah guys, that was the Delta 7 Obi-Wan's Jedi Starfighter. Now I'm really happy with the way this turned out, as I said at the start of this video. The only thing I would add, of course, is tiles. Of course, the reason for that is, like I said at the start, I feel as if I'm repeating myself, but is to just get more tiles onto it, and of course, they're a bit hard to get. So, if you do like the content you see here, please comment, like, and subscribe. Of course, there will be another video released later in the day of the time of the release of this video. And that will, of course, be week one of the Building Umbara series. So that, I just need to get it made, blah, blah, blah. But, yeah, guys, that's going to be it from me. Of course, check out my Instagram. There'll be a link in the description to that. I am Avaro Bricks, and I'll see you guys later. Peace out.